He warmly welcomes every one of you. If you want to say something, he's very like to hear from you.
Well, first I would say we are extremely honored to be here, and we are sorry that this was a surprise meeting, and we certainly accept, there was no need to apologize, and we certainly accept it, and we are, we had no expectation that we would have a meeting like this with
میگم واقعا باعث افتخار ماست که ما خدمت شما رسیدیم و هرچند برای ما اصلا نیازی هم به عذرخواهی نیست ما هم شرمنده هستیم از اینکه بدون اطلاع قبلی و بیشتر مزاحمتون شدیم و به هر حال از اینکه ما رو پذیرفتید خیلی ممنونیم و باعث افتخار برای ما
ادب وجود مبارک مسیح سلام الله علیه است که شما رو کم توقع و آرا بود
This is one of the gifts of the holy and blessed Jesus Christ that have actually trained his followers to be so polite and to be so to have so much courtesy that you accept our apology and to be so polite and
Alhamdulillah
We are a group from Canada and the United States Most of us have never been to Iran before, and we are learning a lot, and it's particularly interesting and important that we have had a number of discussions about Shia Islamic theology and philosophy and the way that Shia Muslims here are living. It's been very impressive, and we've appreciated the opportunity to learn in this way.
ما گروهی از اساتید دانشگاه ها هستیم که از آمریکا و کانادا اومدن در الهیات مسیحی و ارشادهای مرتبط اکثر ما اولین باره که به ایران میام و در حقیقت این سفر آموزشی برای ما بوده و بسیار داریم چیزهای زیادی رو یاد میگیریم در مورد تشیع و در مورد اسلام و واقعا شگفت زده شدیم از مسائلی که دیدیم و چیزهایی که ملاقات هایی که داشتیم بسیار برای ما آموزنده بوده
مقدم شما مبارک باشد امیدواریم سوغات و رهاورد خوبی به همراه داشته باشد
Again, he wants to welcome you greatly and also he hopes that the result of this trip will be something very fruitful and a lot of blessing you will have with you when, as a result of this trip
کسی به جای می رود میراث فرهنگی را مشاهده می کند به همراه خود عکس می برد
So when someone goes to a place and sees the cultural heritage, they take some photos with themselves.
یه عکسی میگیرن وقتی اهرام مصر میرن فقط رهاوردشون یه عکس است دیگه.
For example, when they go and see the pyramids in Egypt, the souvenir that they take and the gift that they take to serve is only a picture.
اما اینجا امیدواریم که پیام انبیا را به همراه
But here we hope that you take the message of the prophets with you as a souvenir to your countries.
I'm sure we will take the message of the prophet and we will also take the friendship of the many people that we are meeting here for the first time or renewing relationships with some of us.
میگه قطعا ما پیام انبیا رو که با خودمون به عنوان سوغاتی خواهیم برد و علاوه بر اون دوستی ها و مهربانی ها و علقه هایی هم که ایجاد شده بین ما و دوستان و مسلمانمون هم این هم به عنوان یه سوغاتی ما از ایران خواهیم برد
یکی از بهترین رهاورد پیام انبیا همین صلح جهانی است
And one of the greatest outcomes of the message of the prophets all of the prophets is the international the world peace that's the message that they had for us
اون چه در جهان کنونی میگذرد اینها بشری فکر میکنن
What's happening in the current world, the unfortunate things that we see in the current world, is one of the results of thinking very worldly.
بشری حرف میزنن.
And talking only worldly from a worldly materialistic aspect.
ولی منظورشون محلی و ملی است.
But they intend to think locally. Correct something. By worldly, he means that everyone talks internationally, and they talk in a way that you think they are addressing everyone. But in reality, what they mean, the politicians, they only care about their own personal or local benefits. They talk internationally, but they don't act internationally. They only care about their own benefits.
بسیاری از افراد هستند که داعیه حقوق بشر دارند ولی محلی فکر میکنند خیال میکنند بشر خودشونه.
There are many people who talk a lot about the human rights, and they say human rights is important, but they think locally, in the sense that they only consider themselves as the humans. They don't have an inclusive way of thinking about others.
همینا که جنگ جهانی اول، جنگ جهانی دوم، کوتاه علیه کشورها و جنگ علیه یمن فرسوده، جنگ علیه فلسطینی‌های بیرون رفته، همه این حرفا رو راه اندازی کردن ولی از حقوق بشر سخن نمی‌گن.
And you see so many people people talk about the human kinds. By that I mean those people who made the second and the first and the second world wars, and those people who are now invading the poor people of Yemen or poor people of many different countries that are under invasion. You see many of them talking about the human rights. They are the people who only talk about that, but when it comes to the thinking and to practicing, they only consider their own selves as the humans, and they exclude other people.
Well, that's why it is so important that we have opportunities to meet people from other places, people of other religions, so that we know them and understand that they are equal to us as human beings, and then we cannot think about going to war against them because they are our friends.
و همین مسئله اهمیت این رو نشون میده که این اهمیت این دیدارها و آشنا شدن ما با سفرهای ما که ما بریم افراد مختلف با همدیگر رو ببینند و ببینند که اینها انسان‌هایی هستند مثل خودشون و اگر بحث جنگی پیش اومد ببینند که اونها دوستان ما هستند و ما نباید علیه دوستانمون و افرادی که مثل خودمون هستند بیایم وارد جنگ و اینها بشیم و این اهمیت این دیدارها رو دوچندان میکنه.
برای که روشن بشه انبیا چی آوردن ما دو نمونه ذکر میکنیم.
In order to clarify what is the message of the prophets, the prophets of God, I want to bring two examples.
نمونه اول جریان داوود پیامبر علیه السلام است.
The first example is the example of David, and you know that David in the Islamic tradition is the prophet.
جریان داوود را همه میشناسیم.
We have heard about David.
پیش همه ما محترم است.
And he is very respected among the faithful people.
او رهبر انقلاب بود.
He was actually like a revolutionary leader.
و جالوت را از پادر آورد.
And he was the one who could defeat Jalut, the Gilead. I don't know. Goliath. Thank you.
احسنت.
well said.
و حکومت تشکیل داد.
And he actually started a rulership of the.
و دشمنانی هم داشت.
And also he had so many opponents.
و قدرت غیبی در تأیید او.
But he was blessed. He received the blessing from God.
باید در تورات انجیل خونده باشید.
You must have read in the Old and the New Testament.
که خدا فرمود.
That God said.
آهن را ما مثل موم در دست او نرم کرد.
We made iron so soft in his hand, so he had such a power.
در قرآن آمده است.
In the Quran we have.
و علنا له الحديد.
We made irons like a soft thing, so he has the power to make things to change iron to a very soft thing by his hand.
همون طوری که موم در دست انسان نرم است.
The same way that the honey, what is that? The honeycomb is so soft, something like so.
Beeswax.
Yeah, the beeswax is so soft. Yeah. The iron in the hand of David was like that, very soft, and he could shape iron by his hand. That's the meaning.
آهن در دست داوود نرم بود.
So he could shape the iron by his hand because it was soft in his hand.
احتیاج به کوره‌های ذوب آهن نداشت.
He didn't need any of the tools and the places to actually dissolve and fire the. Yeah.
خدا فرمود.
God says.
و علمناه صنعت لبوس لکم. یعنی خدا فرمود ما به داوود که رهبر انقلاب بود و حکومت تشکیل داد و قدرت مرکزی به او دادیم، آهن سخت را در دست او مثل موم نرم کردیم و او گفتیم شمشیر نساز، تیر نساز، نیزه نساز، وسایل کشتن نساز، زره بباف که جان مردم محفوظ باشه.
So according to the Quran, God taught him the industry to make shields. This has a message for us. It means that David, as a prophet of God who was given the power of ruling over people, God taught him the knowledge to make shields. It means that God taught him not to make swords, not to make arrows, not to make any war, spears and anything. He didn't. He never. He wanted him not to make any of them, but rather he told him to make something that you can keep people safe and protect other, protect your nation from any of the.
این کار رهبر انقلاب بود.
This was the duty of the leader of that
که هم ما قبول داریم.
That we accepted.
هم شما مسیحی‌ها قبول دارید.
And you also as Christians believe in that type of them.
هم یهودی‌ها قبول دارن.
And also the Jewish people.
و قرآن امضا کرده.
And Quran has confirmed this way of thinking to protect
اما نمونه ourselves. دیگر.
And the other example is
فرزند همین داوود سلیمان پیغمبر.
Solomon the prophet was son of David.
حکومت سلیمان حکومت جهانی بود.
And he had a like a world rule. He had a rulership over most parts of the world at that time.
سلسله کوه‌ها تابع بودند.
He was so powerful that according to the tradition, it is said that even the mountains were under his power and were instructing his orders.
پرنده‌ها پیروی می‌کردند.
They said that in the tradition that the birds of the sky obeyed his instructions.
جنها اطاعت میکردند.
The jinns obeyed him.
قدرتی از این بالاتر فرض نمیشود.
No one has been depicted such a great power, a power more than this.
در تورات آمده، در انجیل آمده، در قرآن آمده.
It's in the Old and in the New Testament and also in the Quran.
که اصل ناله عین القطر، یعنی معدن قطر یعنی مصر، معدن مصر را ما مثل آب روان برای او مسلط کردیم.
We made the metals actually mines. Something like the rivers for him. He had domination over all the gifts of the earth.
اصلنا یعنی سیلوار این معدن مصر را در اختیارش قرار دادیم.
Some of the metal mines were like the floods of water at his hand, so he could use whatever he wanted.
این سلیمان.
This Solomon.
با این قدرت مرکزی.
With such a great power.
دستور داد.
He instructed.
از این مصر روان.
To make from these metals that you could get from the earth,
ظروف مختلف بسازن.
To make a lot of plates and dishes,
ظرف‌های دیک بسازن.
And pots,
بشقاب بسازن.
And other instruments that they needed to.
سایر ظروف لازم بسازن.
And other necessary.
هرگز دستور نداد سلاح کشتار بسازن.
And he never, Solomon, as the most powerful king in the Abrahamic traditions, he never ordered any of his followers to make any weapons or any war instruments.
اینها رهبران الهی ما هستند.
These are the divine or divinely confirmed leaders that we need to follow.
نمونه سوم را در خود اسلام بشنوید.
And the third example is in the Islamic tradition.
مرحوم کلینی از بزرگترین محدثان ماست.
Kulaini is one of the greatest compilers of the sayings of the Imams and the Prophets, a muhaddis.
او نقل میکند.
He says that
یک سوال کننده ای
someone came and asked
آمده از محضر امام مطلب میپرسد.
And asked one of the imams.
این سوال کننده
the questioner
فروشنده شمشیر و سلاح‌های جنگی بود.
Is someone whose job was to sell sword and other war instruments.
به امام عرض کرد.
He said to imam.
دو منطقه اند که هیچ کدام مسلمان نیستند.
There are two districts that none of them are Muslims.
و با هم در جنگ هم.
And they are in fight with each other. Two tribes, non-Muslim tribes, and they are fighting with each other.
فروش اسلحه سودآور است.
And I can gain a lot of money by selling swords and other war instruments to those tribes.
هر دو گروه از ما اسلحه میخواهند.
And both of them ask me to sell war instruments to them.
برای ما نفع هم دارد.
And it will bring a lot of benefits to us, interest and money to us if I do that.
آیا به اینها بفروشیم یا نه؟
Am I allowed to sell war instruments to them or not?
وجود مبارک امام ششم ما چنین فرمود.
Imam Sadiq at the sixth Imam of the Shia, who was the person who was asked, he said,
بعهما ما یکنهما، یعنی اسلحه بفروشید یک، به هر دو گروه بفروشید دو، لکن فقط سلاح دفاعی مثل سپر، مثل زره، مثل خود، مثل چکمه بفروشید.
He said, if you want to sell these types of instruments, you can sell them only provided that you sell to both of them, but not the swords. You can only sell things that they can defend themselves, like the shields and other types of things that they can protect themselves. You have no right to sell swords and other offensive, instruments.
هرچند اون دو منطقه با ما هم فکر نیستن، ولی آدم کشی چیز بدی است.
Although they don't think the same way, they are different in their religion. They think differently than us, but still. Killing another human being is something that we never confirm.
این سه نمونه،
these three examples،
پیام همه پیامبران الهی
is the message of all the divine prophets.
الان شما میبینید،
now you see that
کارخونه های اسلحه آدم کشی،
there are so many great factories that make guns just in order to kill people.
در آمریکا و از ناب آمریکا سه شیفته مشغول کار.
And in the United States there are big factories of making war instruments and guns that are working 24/7.
هر جای جهان را ببینید خون ریزی است.
If you look at any part of the world, you see that there are clashes and there are wars and battles.
ما که لباس دین در بر داریم،
for people like us who have the who are known as the religious people،
چه علمای اسلام،
either the Islamic scholars،
چه علمای مسیحیت،
or the Christian activists and scholars،
چه علمای یهود،
or Jewish scholars،
چه علمای زردشت،
or Zoroastrian scholars.
هر کس میگوید خدا،
anyone who talks about God or divine،
دو تا وظیفه دارد،
has two main duties.
اول اتفاق داخلی،
first of all is the internal unity and integration and unity among themselves.
دوم دعوت جهان به صلح.
And then the second important duty of all the believers is to invite the whole world to peace.
امیدواریم،
we hope that
این جزء پیام هایی باشد که به همراه به عنوان رهاورد میبرید.
I hope that this is one of the messages that you take with you to your countries as one of the souvenirs of the country, the message of peace and
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Peace and blessings of God to all of you.